Next, coming to the concept of UMTS IMT 2000. So what are the features and objectives of this particular UMTS and IMT 2000? Actually, what is UMTS and what is IMT 2000? Here, UMTS is nothing but it's Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. It is nothing but it's a third generation mobile cellular system for the networks, which is based on GSM standard. And it was developed and maintained by 3GPP, that is third generation partnership project. So here UMTS is nothing but it's a component of IMT 2000 standard. IMT stands for International Telecommunications Union standard set, and it compares with CDMA 2000 standard set for networks that are based on competing CDMA 1 technology. Here the UMTS, it uses WCDMA, which is similar to that of 4G technology, that is wideband code division multiple access radio access technology, which offers greater spectral efficiency and the bandwidth for the mobile network operators. So here the UMTS, it specifies a complete network system, which includes the radio access networks such as UMTS, terrestrial radio access network, or else you can call it as UTRAN, and also the core network, that is mobile application part MAP, and the authentication of users via SIM, that is subscriber identity module cards. So whatever the technology that is described in UMTS, it is sometimes also called as freedom of mobile multimedia access. I repeat, freedom of mobile multimedia access, FOMA, or 3GSM, because it's a standard based on the third generation GSM. It's also called as 3GSM. UMTS, it requires new base stations and new frequency allocations, unlike GSM and CDMA 2000. And coming to the what are the features that are used in UMTS is, it supports a maximum data transfer rate of 42 Mbps when HSPA technology is implemented. HSPA is nothing but high speed project application. Okay, HSPA, what is a HSPA in mobile communication means? It's a high speed packet access technology. It's a combination of two mobile protocols, that is high speed uplink packet access and high speed downlink packet access, which extends and it improves the performance of normal existing 3G communication networks using wideband code division multiple access protocols. So what is this particular HSPA in a mobile network means? It is deployed and a popular mobile broadband technology within GSM family of technologies. It has combination of both the high-speed data packet access 3GPP release 5 and high-speed uplink packet access. Uplink and downlink packet access technologies are there. It is a combination of these two when they are deployed in a network. This mainly HSPA, it builds upon third generation UMTS or WCDMA technology. Next, it uses frequency division duplexing or a time division duplexing method. And it has wideband multimedia mobile services. So this UMTS, it's also known as 3.5G, that is third generation 3GPP release 5, call us. Next, it supports the transfer rate of 384 kilobits per second for UMTS original and 7.2 Mbps for high-speed downlink packet access technique. Next, the maximum data rate for the indoor, it is 2 Mbps, and for the mobile, it is 384 kbps. And the next one, high-speed downlink packet access, it enables downlink transfer speed of about or up to 21 Mbps. That is, it uses binary phase shift keying for uplink and quadrature phase shift keying for downlink. So these are the features of UMTS. And coming to the objectives, it is a third generation mobile cellular network, as I've already told you, for the networks that are based on GSM standards. And it was developed and maintained by 3GPP, that is third generation. It's a component of International Mobile Telecommunication 2000 standard, similar to that of CDMA 1 and CDMA 2000, International Telecommunication Users. And it uses wideband code division multiple access for greater efficiency and the more bandwidth for the network mobile operators. And the main feature of this one is, unlike Edge system or IMT 2000, it requires new base station and a new frequency allocation. Next, it specifies a complete network system, which radio access network, core network, and authentication of the users. So these are the objectives and features of UMTS, that is Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. Next, coming to the features of IMT 2000. What is IMT 2000 and what is this 2000 standard, and what is the capacities and what are the technologies that are 3G technologies, major 3G technologies proposed for IMT 2000. Let us start to discuss. Actually, the 3G technology, what is the current cellular system we are using? Previously, the current cellular system is referred to as 2G cellular. It differs from the first generation system. Here, the IMT 2000, that is International Mobile Telecommunication 2000, is used with the hope of having it operational by the year 2000 in 2000 megahertz range. This IMT 2000 vision is, it has common spectrum worldwide, that is 2.8 to 2.2 gigahertz band, and it is able to operate in multiple environments, not only confined to a cellular, that is cordless, satellite, LANs, wireless, local loop, and all. And it has wide range of telecommunication services, that is data, voice, multimedia, etc. And it has flexible radio bearers for increased spectrum efficiency, and the data rates is of 9.6 kilobits per second or also higher for global services. And 144 kbps for vehicular, 384 kbps for pedestrian, and up to 2 mbps for indoor environments. These particular values can be confined to that particular value, or also it may be higher depending upon the condition. And it has enhanced security, and the performance is also high. It is fully integrated of wireless and wireline services. Next, this what are the technologies proposed for IMT 2000 are WCDMA, next CDMA1, that is IS95 standard, CDMA 2000, and IS136 standard is also has been evolved for its own migration to 3G, that is Universal Wireless Communication 136 has been used. So this IMT 2000 is offered by the Japanese, Koreans, Europeans, and US also. What are the services and capabilities of this particular IMT 2000 is 2G technology will support including registration, authentication, encryption, SMS, emergency calling, and the bit rates, it has I've already explained you that 144 kbps, 384 kbps, 2 mbps for vehicular, pedestrian, and for indoor environments. And the billing and charging activities for the user profiles is sharing of information between service providers is possible, and call recording is possible in detail, and it has standard user profiles. Next, it supports geographic position finding services for the mobile and also for the network, and it supports multimedia services like quality of service, asymmetric links, fixed and variable rate, and bit rates of up to 2 mbps. And it supports packet services, the internet access, it is wireless cellular IP. Next, what is the main IMT 2000 family concept is, it defines some basic interoperability capabilities between different IMT 2000 technologies in order to enable global roaming services. So what are the different radio access networks used here means CDMA 2000, WCDMA, Universal Wireless Communication 136. And the different core network standards are IS41, GSM, ISDN. Okay, so this is about the brief explanation of IMT 2000. And let us start with the discussion of features. What are the features of IMT 2000? So it has high degree of flexibility, and the cost, it is cost effective in all operating conditions, and it has commonality of design for the worldwide. This operation of IMT 2000 is possible for terrestrial and satellite components within the bands of WARC-92 for the worldwide used, which are identified by WARC-92. These are the features of IMT 2000. And coming to the objectives, the main purpose of IMT is to provide global roaming services, and it includes various paging, cordless, cellular, mobile data, and mobile satellite systems. It has common spectrum worldwide from 1.8 to 2.2 gigahertz bandwidth. And the fundamental part of IMT 2000 is the concept of, it has lightweight and convenient packet communicator, and is also called as 2G system. And it has enhanced performance and high security. The main aim of this one is, it aims for highly cost effective radio access network, and it has wide range of telecommunication services, and it can able to operate in multiple environments. So this is about UMTS IMT 2000 features and objectives. Next, we'll discuss about edge system. What is an edge system? Edge system is nothing but it's a 4G technology. The full form of this one is enhanced data GSM environment. Okay. So it is edge computing. It's nothing but it's a distributing computing that brings computation and data storage close to the location wherever it is needed to improve response times and save bandwidth. So what are the features and edge system for the wireless communication? We'll discuss about it. Okay. This enhanced data rates for the global evolution as well as protocol enhancement for transmitting the packet over the radio. It can be easily implemented on GSM and GPRS networks. So this enhanced data rates for GSM evolution is also known as enhanced GPRS, EGPRS, and IMT single carrier, that is IMT SC, or enhanced data rates for global evolution. So these are the different names that can be used for the edge. And which is nothing but it's a digital mobile phone technology that allows improved data transmission rates, that which is an extension of GSM. So what is the main difference between edge and GSM means? This edge, it stands for, the name itself indicates, it has enhanced data rates for GSM evolution or environment. It is also termed as enhanced GPRS, I have already told you. But this is a technology that uses same equipment as GSM, but with small, only few minor modifications are provided in edge system so that it can provide faster data speeds, and often it is regarded as stepping stone towards 3G. Thus, it is also called as 2.5 generation technology. And coming to the points here, it is the fastest version of GSM technology, which is used to deliver data rates up to 384 kbps. And it enables the delivery of multimedia and other broadband applications for the mobile phones and the computer users also. And it uses the TDMA frame structure. And because for the GSM, the TDMA frame structure is often required. So here also, it is similar to the GSM. It also uses TDMA frame structure and existing cell arrangements. And this, it is also called as GSM 384. It provides a speed enhancement by changing type of modulation used and making better use of carriers currently used. This enhanced data for global evolution, and it provides nearly 3 times faster speed than outdated GPRS system. Both phone and network, it must support edge. Otherwise, the phone will switch automatically to GPRS. If the phone and network supports the edge system, then it's okay. Otherwise, the phone will switch automatically to the GPRS technology, GPRS system, General Packet Radio Service. So this is about edge system. Thank you.